you. Thank you. Thank you and welcome to the one-year anniversary of Marty's Corner Live tonight from the VFW Hall in the City of Industry. Can you hear the VFW Hall one time? The VFW Hall. Now, a lot of people have never seen this show before, and we have an incredible audience here tonight. If you're watching this, come on down. We're down at the VFW Hall, and we'd love to have you down. This show has been a long time in the coming. Not just this show in particular, but the whole concept of Marty's Corner. We started this about 3 years ago, I guess, and it's finally got to the point now where it's gone to this magnitude. And when we first started, in fact, we started a year ago tomorrow. A year ago tomorrow was our first show here on Channel 33. And the show was a little ragged. We hadn't got all the bugs out, right? Isn't that right?
Right.
Okay. And we haven't got all the bugs out, but we tried our damnedest. And
darndest.
We could, what's that?
Darndest.
I'm sorry, that's right, we're on prime time. Darndest. But the show was a little bit ragged. And if we could, let's go ahead and run that videotape. If you were at home last year, August 20th, and you had your TV set turned to Channel 33, this is what you would have saw at 8 o'clock. Let's go ahead and roll the video, if we could, in the hall.
Let's roll that video.
It's Marty's Corner. Tonight, join Marty and his guests, Clown Cop Terry Mace, Funny Man Jack Benson, Classical Belly Dancer Fatim, and the alternative rock sound of Monkeys to Go. The Corner Band and the Marty Dancers.
Welcome to Marty's Corner. Hi, I'm your host, Marty Shields, and it's Friday night. It's 8 o'clock by our clock, and it's almost the weekend. We hope you stay with us for a while for the next hour and find out what's going on this weekend and what's on tonight and tomorrow and the rest of the week. You're a great audience. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Corner Band and, of course, the Marty Shields Dancers. Frank, take it away. It's live anymore. No microphone. This is great. That was our first show, ladies and gentlemen. Can we remember the first show, huh?
Come on, everybody. Be charitable. Come on. Have a heart. We're not getting paid for this. Hey, I know those people.
But we try with all of our heart. This time, like I said, we're here not only to celebrate the one-year anniversary of Marty's Corner, but for a larger cause, and that is the charities that we're going to be benefiting tonight. And at this time, I'd like to bring on a gentleman who will speak more about the monies that will be donated tonight here at the VFW Hall. Can you please give a warm welcome to the commander of Post 1944, Jim King. Jim, come on out. Now, Jim, there are two charities that we're working for tonight. And what are those charities, and where is the money going?
Well, we deal with Buddy Puppies, which deals with our disabled veterans. They assemble in May and November of every year on street corners, markets you'll go to. You'll see these guys in funny hats trying to hand you a red flower. Donate to them because it's assembled by disabled veterans, and we sell them, and the money goes back to them to help them.
And the POWMI Foundation, what's done there?
Oh, Marty, that's one of the biggest ones we do. Until we get an accounting for all our veterans from Vietnam, Korea, World War II. We still donate money to groups that fight for this and legislate. And you people here, by your donation tonight, thank you, because we'll continue to fight to get accounting for every, till every veteran's accounted for.
Can you hang around a while, Jim? Can you hang around a while?
Sure.
We need to go to a commercial break for 3 minutes, but we'll be right back. Band, take us out of here and go, fellas. Ladies and gentlemen, the Corner Band. As I alluded to at the beginning of the show, it's not a one-man job here at Marty's Corner. I can do what I'm doing with all the support, and that includes the Corner Band behind me, all the techs, all the volunteers here, but one special lady who has been with us from the get-go. She initially started out as a Marty dancer and has elevated herself into my co-host. She sits to the left of me, but she's never left out. So if we could, let's go ahead and run that videotape, if we could, in the hall of my co-host. Guys, take it away.
Your name again is?
Lori.
That's correct.
You're lying. No.
Lori, you married?
Yes.
Happily?
Yes.
Good. Glad to hear it, Lori.
Wait, are
working,
you?
Bill.
No, I'm not. Now, Lori, we have three ropes, probably ropes very similar to those that you and your husband have in your bedroom, right?
Lori, go ahead.
Oh, are we going to take turns?
Yes, we're going to go back and forth.
There we go.
Cute. Okay. We never did that before. Sent me this chain letter because it's from the city of industry. I don't know. And did you send me a chain letter, Thomas?
It comes with bad luck now.
And it says I'll die if I don't send, like, money. Why would he say that? But I have to give this plug for my hairdresser, Danny, who's appearing in this piece by Rachel Rosenthal. And that's Danny is appearing as a throng in this piece.
A throng.
So I'm going to try and see that tomorrow night.
Also, you did your hair recently?
Yes.
Beautiful.
Well,
tell us, you told me earlier, we've known each other a couple months now since the show started. Tell us about what it was, your only claim to fame was. Your only claim to fame?
Well, actually, there's two claim to fames, but I don't have a picture. Oh. The first claim to fame is that I was on the Girl Scout cookie box around 1982. I couldn't find the box. I looked everywhere today, but I did find
my... I wouldn't eat those cookies to fire you. I think that the expiration date is way gone.
A wonderful organization.
But I did find my spread in a Japanese magazine there. If you
can you say that on TV?
Will.
I think you can.
And you just kind of go with me on that.
Well, sure thing, Mark.
So, Lori, I heard you did that play recently in the Pasadena Playhouse. Now, it went real well. Is that right?
Yes, it did, Marty.
And last but not least, the sidekick and the announcer on the show, can you please give a warm welcome to Lori Sobrito Jimenez. Lori! Ladies and gentlemen, at this time I'd like to bring out a very talented lady and a beautiful woman, my sidekick, Lori Sobrito Jimenez. Lori! give it to you. I'm going to leave. Lori, it's all yours.
Oh, okay. You're going? I'm so used to you being to the right of me, this is throwing me all off. Come hold my hand, Marty. No. Okay, well, tonight we have two comedians coming up, and they have billed themselves the Mad Lady and the Mad Man of Comedy, Mary Ramis. I promised her I'd say that right. I've been practicing all week. I've been saying Ramis all week, and I get here, and she says it's Ramis. So it's Mary Ramis and Tim Hannon are here tonight. So will you please, as Marty says, give a warm welcome to Mary Ramis.
Good evening. How's everybody doing tonight? All right. Well, congratulations. Happy anniversary. Marty, you've done a great job. Give it up. Give it up. I'm a woman of the 90s. I'm financially independent. I'm sexually independent. And I'm a bitch. Woo-hoo! Oh, yeah, honey. I'm actually nicer when I'm having my period. And I don't cook either. Ladies, who has time for this? No way. Hey, you know what? I'd rather give a guy a blowjob than make him dinner. Oh, yeah, honey, because it doesn't take as much time and there's a lot less stuff to clean up. Oh, yeah, and this year I decided, hey, I need a little culture, dolls. So I'm branching out. Yeah, I'm taking a foreign language, Vietnamese. Yeah, I figure it'll really come in handy when I travel abroad to Westminster. And ladies, I'm so excited because I'm finally going to know what all those women are saying about me where I get my nails done. Yeah, and everywhere I go lately, I keep running into all these really old people. You know those people. They go to the store, they get in their car, and they never pull out of the parking space. Yeah, you're sitting behind them going, what are you doing in there? Are you going pee-pee in your Dependos? No, they're sitting there in their car going, did I go to the store or did I just get here? Maybe if I look in the trunk, I could get a clue. Yeah, and what kind of a car am I going to be driving when I'm 90? A real big Cadillac, that's what. Yeah, with real big rubber bumpers, a bifocal windshield, and a driver's side drool bag. And as you can tell, dolls, I'm kind of unusual. Yeah, because I'm aggressive, I'm competitive, and I can't make a commitment. I'm your basic guy. Oh, yeah, honey. Oh, yeah. Mm-mm-mm, honey, just give me a penis and a pickup truck and I'm there. Oh, yeah, and you know, I'm kind of fascinated by the male appendage and how it works. And maybe some of you men are, too. And I just wonder, you know, if I had one of those, would I wear it on the left or would I wear it on the right? And when it gets really hot out, does it stick to the inside of your leg? I don't know. I just wish we could send all the penises to obedience school. Yeah, so they would respond on command. Yeah, like sit up. Oh no, honey, way up. Oh, good boy, good boy. Stay. Oh no, honey, if you do that now, you're gonna have to clean that up. Yeah, and you know, I'm not very mechanical either, folks. No, I'm not. You know, the first time a plumber came to my house and said, hey, hand me a nipple. I said, which one? So ever since then, I've been studying men's tools, dolls, and it's been kind of fun. Yeah. Oh, it's not what you think. I've been looking at the Sears Craftsman catalog, and I found some stuff in there I could really use. Yeah, like a butt chisel. That would be a lot cheaper than liposuction, dolls. And they even had this weird thing in the catalog called a stopcock. But who would want to do that? I don't know. I did find a great gift for my ex-husband, though. A prick punch. Yeah, and dolls, I have no luck with men, but I finally figured out why. It's because I live here in Orange County, or down in Orange County, and I don't look like Barbie or Ken. Yeah, I mean, don't get me wrong. I just got kind of upset because the last time I went to the toy store, the only Ken doll they had was Glitter Beach Ken. I'm like, excuse me? No. We need some new Ken dolls, you know, ones that are more realistic of what us ladies are going to get when we grow up. Yeah, like Potbelly Ken. Yeah, he comes with a remote control, a can of beer, and a sofa strapped to his ass. Or how about my all-time favorite Ken doll? The Ken Bobbitt doll. Yeah, his penis is sold separately. All right, that's my time. I love you guys. Thank you very much. My name's Mary Ramos. Thank you. Thank you very much. Hey, you guys are going to love this next guy coming to the stage. He is the mad man of comedy. Give it up for Tim Henin. Yeah!
How you doing? All right. Gotta love this place. And I told you guys before, last time I was on this show, that I'd be back. Yeah, that's right. I told you if this comedy thing didn't work out, you know, I had another plan. I ain't making a lot of money yet, so I'm still considering that feature story on America's Most Wanted. Yeah, that's right. I guess I better tell you all a little bit about myself. Because I'm sure at first glance you all thought I was a politician. Well, you weren't too far off, and this may come as a shock to y'all, but I've smoked pot before. Yep, that's right. My political ambitions kind of went up in smoke one day when I inhaled. But yeah, okay, yeah, I'm your average guy. I come home from a hard day at work, sit down in front of the TV. I got the channel checker for the TV, the VCR, the CD, the cable box. I got the clapper hooked up to a blender full of margaritas. Yeah, that coffee table looks like the control panel for a starship. So I kick the starship Lazy Boy into launch position, and I'm off to another planet. That's right, the other day I'm sitting there, I'm watching that show Cops, you know. And they're busting people for the seatbelt law, the helmet law. I'm thinking, damn, we spend a lot of money trying to protect us from ourselves. I'm waiting for them to kick down the door at Burger King. Okay, fatso, drop that whopper! Come on over here, blowing this tube. We're checking your cholesterol right here, pal. During the holidays, they'll have them little cholesterol checkpoints all over the neighborhood. And there's the other side of the coin, you know. They got murderers, rapists, killers. They don't do a damn thing about it. I think we ought to hook that electric chair up to the clapper, and them boys are out of there. Ha-ha! We might even be able to profit off the deal. We'll have a little game show. We'll call it Hot Seat. I can see it now, ladies and gentlemen. We have Jeffrey Dahmer in the hot seat. Can you give him a big hand? Yeah! Gotta love it. And yeah, we spend a lot of money trying to protect us from ourselves, and we spend even more money trying to protect stupid people from themselves. You know, go out to the national park, take out all them signs that say don't feed the bears. You're stupid to feed a bear. You probably deserve to be mauled. Take out the guardrails. If you're dumb enough to drive off the road, you probably deserve to be in a wreck. Put up more of them signs that say, look for fallen rocks. You know, the stupid people will be so busy looking for fallen rocks, they'll spin off the road where we took out the guardrails. That's right. Everybody's sniveling about these mountain lion attacks these days. You know, but if we were a herd, they'd only take the weak and the stupid. Ha ha! Gotta love it. Where's that guy with that cute thing? I'm rolling on. Okay, I got plenty of time. What else do I want to talk? I don't talk about you guys. Let me see. Anybody out here into that country western stuff? Yeehaw! Yeah! I can relate to you people, you know? Last week I stepped in a big pile of something, found myself doing the boot scoot boogie. That's right. That bush push, tush push, I do that whenever I can. Yeah, you betcha. Because I'm not just funny looking. Ha ha. And then pro-lifers out there? Yeah, I never see them guys. Oh, we got one. Where is he? He is just kidding. Anyways, you know, I was just wanted to walk up to one of them people and just punch him as hard as I could right in the face and say, hey, don't you wish my mother had an abortion now? Yeah. Oh, okay, well, hey, I better get out of here before my PO shows up here looking for me. So you guys have a good time in Marty's Corner and wish him a happy anniversary. Yeah. Oh.
Tim Hennett, Crazy Tim. Oh my God, get him out of here. Like I said, we don't do the show by ourselves, and the gentleman behind me, the Corner Band, I consider them the best three-man band in talk show right now. The Corner Band, ladies and gentlemen, I thank them. We'd like to go ahead and show you a videotape of some of the best of the Corner Band over the last years, if there is any. Let's go ahead and run that VT in the hall, the Corner Band, real quick.
I want peace on earth and goodwill towards men.
Oh, okay. This is our bass player, Albert. Albert, what do you want for the new year?
Beer, and more beer.
Oh! And way in the back, we got Jim. Jim, what do you want for a happy new year?
A better economy so we can all make more money.
Yeah. What a wicked thing to say. It never felt this way.
The guys in the band were on Rice Krispies. Here's the shot of the band. And I want to know which one of you guys is Snap. I know who Crackle is. I want to know who Snap is. Frank, which one? Yeah. And that's the shot of the band. We're here for the band, ladies and gentlemen. The Corner Band.
Thank you, Marty.
Ladies and gentlemen, my pleasure to introduce the Corner Band.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Again, I'd like to introduce Jim Martin, a drummer. Albert Alcarez, our bass player. And I'm your host, Frank Atencio.
Again.
for being very supportive for us through the last year. All right. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, my family, ladies and gentlemen. You're all my family. Through the year, Marty's Corner, we've tried to get probably the best, the cream of the crop of local musicians, and failing that, we have assembled a great array of people who are amateur musicians and burgeoning professional people. I don't know what the hell I'm saying, so here comes the video clip. Here comes the video clip. Here comes the video clip.
If you look inside your heart, you don't have to be afraid of what you are.
That was our year of music. Now I'd like to introduce a cool bunch of guys for their second appearance on Marty's Corner. As they all get ready, Roadkill, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah. Yeah. Gone. She's gone away from me. We'll be right back in 3 minutes. What, guys, why don't you get us out of here? Take it away. Roadkill, one time. There we go.
Live, folks, as Marty always says, things happen when you're live. The next act, you guys are going to really enjoy, especially the gentleman. Oh, we're doing the video clip first of Fatim and Sultan's Delight. Dancers in general, what do I know? I just work here. I show up, I do the job. I just got the job. I didn't have any training. Okay. Video of the dancers first, then we're gonna have Fatim and Sultan's Delight. Here we go. Our first show, so she's very special. She was on the first Marty's Corner a year ago. 1 year, it's hard to believe, it's gone fast. Please welcome, she has her group with her tonight, Fatim and Sultan's Delight. Gentlemen, get ready.
Thank you.
our first guest we ever had in Marty's Corner. We need to go away for a 3-minute break, but we'll be right back. And the band is not around, so let's go ahead and all sing, Take Me Out to the Ball Game. Take me out to the ball game. Take me out to the crowd. Give me some peanuts and Cracker Jack. I don't care if I ever get back, or it's root for the Dodgers. If they don't win, it's a shame, everybody. And it's 1, 2, 3 strikes, you're out at the old ball game.
And when Pac-Man comes to the door, I'll then point a can at you. It ain't me. It ain't me. I'm no Saturday night son. It ain't me.
I said, doing this show for the last year, we've had a lot of support from the community, and that's the best thing about Community Access Television. We have a wine somewhere. Frankie, may I have your microphone? No. We've had an opportunity over the last year to go around and go to different community places and do videos and stuff. What we're going to show you now is the best of Man on the Street. If we can, let's go ahead and roll that videotape in the hall. John and Craig, take it away. Best of Man on the Street.
Yes.
Yeah. Someone's talking.
Do you know how hot it is outside?
Isn't that 105, yeah, sure. I think? What? Who are you?
What's your name? I'm Happy the Clown. Happy's been taking too much of that helium, I think. Happy, now what do you do exactly with all these beautiful balloons?
Well, I walk around the mall, smile at the children, wave to them, and try to sell balloons.
I think Happy spends too much time by himself. How hot would you guess it is outside?
You know what? We've seen a billboard that said 101. So
101?
I think it's more than that, too.
What is that in Celsius?
Gosh, I guess it's about 300.
300 is what it is in Celsius.
Hey, what is this?
Is it hot outside?
Yes.
How hot would you guess it is outside?
50 or something.
50 degrees is about right, Elias. 100 degrees? Somewhere about 50 or 100. Thank you so much, and it was really nice talking to you, and I hope you have a long and illustrious career. How hot would you guess it is outside?
Right now?
Yeah.
100.
She nailed it, 100. She not only does this for a living, but she can nail how hot it is outside. Do you know how hot that is? Oh, my God. Oh, Jesus. Oh, that's just as horrendous. God, I look like a bad German prostitute or something. Doesn't that look terrible? That is just horrible. I got a bird on my head. What is that? Look at like the Ronca Lake over there on the side coming. Oh, I look like a mass murderer. That's Charlie Manson and the family. Do you have any favorite poems that you'd like to recite for the crowd?
No, I ain't got no poems.
No poems? Do you know any of Edgar Allan Poe's poems, like The Raven or,
yeah,
or Telltale Heart?
Yeah.
Do you know any poems you'd like to recite for us?
Not today.
This is one of my favorite poems by Edgar Allan Poe. Then I would awake to the terror of the lone lake. Yet that terror was not fright, but a tremulous delight. A feeling not the jeweled mine could teach or bribe me to define, nor love, although the love were mine. Death was in that poisonous wave, and in its gulf a fitting grave for him who thence could solace bring to his lone imagining, whose solitary soul could make an Eden of that dim lake.
It's not supposed to be hurting.
What kind of problems do C's have during the year as far as...
Oh, what I'm supposed to do is weigh each employee before they start shift and weigh them at the end to see how much candy they've eaten. No, I'm just kidding.
And do you find that they do that, have a chance to pick up a couple pounds?
Yeah, over their time, I'm sure they do, but...
Do they hire thin people or heavy people here at C's?
They all look like they eat well.
And this is toffee you cover with a sprinkling of nuts.
Almonds.
Almonds. Mm-hmm. Oh. What's this? Great. What time? Excuse me. Man, that is pure chocolate.
Boy.
Isn't that delicious? That's delicious. So if I buy this for my wife, chances are I'll have a good time on the 14th?
I think so.
Are you guaranteed? Does she have a guarantee?
Yes, yes.
Olivia, the manager, says we have a guarantee on this.
Quality without compromising.
Quality without compromising.
Do you ever feel that maybe her presence or the feeling of Mary C. is around you all the time?
Oh, yes. Always.
Do you feel like it kind of hovers over the store? And
yes, with her candy.
Is that and yes. She pretty much watches over you?
Watches,
and
yes.
Making sure that Rodney, the security guard, is not not sleeping over there and doing his job?
By weighing us, yes.
Now, Francisco, my wife would really like to dress up something very scary this year. By any chance, do you have a Sandra Bernhardt costume here at Francisco's?
No, we don't.
Geek. Do you have the quarterback of the Rams, Jim Effort's costume here at Francisco's?
What's he look like?
Well, lately he hasn't looked like too much, actually.
Geek, geek.
Francisco, do you have the Lyle and Eric Menendez costume along with the 12-gauge double-pump shotgun here at Francisco's?
All the accessories, everything needed.
Does that also come with the half-ass alibi?
Sure does.
Fantastic.
Wow, man, this is really cool being at Francisco's, man. Well, look, Madonna's clothes. Let's burn them.
Sally, do you know what Kmart's price promise is?
Nope.
Hey, guys, give the poor TV guy some space to skate.
I love to watch Marty's Corner. It's absolutely a fabulous show.
See Marty's Corner?
Yes, sir, I have.
You have seen my show before?
Yes, sir.
That's great. Marty, Marty, thank you. All right, go on, get away. Go on, hey. Thank you.
Thank you. We're gonna go ahead and go to another video. We're changing the time because we're live and we're going as we go. We're gonna go ahead and do the best of. This is about a minute and a half bit, I believe. Is that right? Some of the funny things that have happened throughout the year, and then we'll go on with the show. So let's go ahead and run that bit if we could, and we'll carry on with the show and get me off the air. Go ahead.
What kind of suggestions do you give people actually out there drinking? I mean, what you know, I'm a big guy, and I have a tendency to drink a lot, too, but I hold it pretty well, at least I think I do. What is the actual, what can I drink without actually getting ripped out of my mind?
Milk, water, and pop.
And Lori, will you please join me? Now, what should we do to actually learn how to do this? Lori has some formal training in dance, but I don't know anything. So where do we start? No. I don't need to be asked twice. Take it away. No. Okay.
I specialize in children and hard cases. I'll take it.
But something that you're going to be known to the eye of the public. Do you understand me, what I'm telling you?
Yes.
But you've got to be a little bit more stronger within yourself. You've been losing sleep over the last past maybe 3-4 months, I would say. Seriously.
Yeah.
You smile a lot within the face, but you carry everything inside. Do you have any questions, Mark?
But I think this one's going to be a lot better than what they got going on, huh? Don't you think so, huh? Hey,
it doesn't matter!
We'll be right back to a commercial. Don't go away, guys. Get us out of here. Ladies and gentlemen, the RSN.
Wasn't that wonderful? All right. Now I'd like to introduce John Kenneth Martin, Rodney Boyer, and Rodney Boyer, two musicians extraordinaire.
Oh, that's great.
That's beautiful music. Let's hear it again one more time. Very talented. All right, are you guys ready for some more funny guys? We got a couple more coming up. Michelin Webb and Ron McCoy are with us tonight. And I know that you guys are faithful Marty Corner watchers. You watch every month faithfully, so you'll remember they were on our December and April shows, respectively. So please give a welcome to Michelin Webb.
Yeah. This is great. How's everybody doing? Are you good?
Yeah.
Right on. Anybody, you guys watch a lot of daytime TV. Anybody see where this woman spent like $50,000 in order to look like Barbie? Yeah. The only thing I could think of was it must have been pretty painful to have those nipples removed. Oh. I don't know, I bought a Barbie for my niece. I bought her charity benefit Barbie. Who is she having this charity benefit for? For all those disabled Barbies that you can buy? I guess she could fundraise to buy clothes for those naked troll dolls. How about an operation for Betsy Wetsy to help her with that embarrassing bladder problem? I don't know, though. Barbie's kind of funny. What would have helped me when I was a kid would have been a Barbie with a PMS timer. Ladies, are you with me? I think once a month, Barbie's tiny little tummy should have blooded out to here. I think her hair should have frizzed, and I think her roots should have shown. And since Barbie always has those really cool accessories, she could have them. She'd have those big old baggy sweatpants and a ratty bathrobe. She'd have those tiny little cartons of Haagen-Dazs and a sawed-off shotgun. Because I think she'd need that. Can't you just see PMS Barbie storming around the Malibu dream home? Ken would be nowhere to be found. I mean, he's not stupid. And just as she hits the height of her cycle, she'd get a knock on the door from Charity Benefit Barbie asking for a donation. That's when the shotgun is most useful, by the way. I was in traffic the other day, and I saw this guy who had a personalized license plate that said, "Hate to wait." Did this guy not have to go to the DMV to get this license plate? It was the only thing he could remember when he got to his window. Hate to wait, good, let's go with it. But at least that's truthful. A lot of times you see these personalized license plates and they're more like a personal ad. Like, you see them and they say one thing, but we all know that they really mean something else. I saw this guy who had "My Awesome Beamer" on his car. Okay, translated, this guy's overcompensating for his little Beamer. Another really popular one is like a car for a girl, like a Vets for Buffy. Translated, this woman's husband bought her a car because he's having an affair. And let's just say, no matter where you are, if you ever see a car with a personalized license plate that says bitch on it, oh man, pull over to the side of the road. Treat it like it was an emergency vehicle, because this helps me get where I'm going. I never really wanted a personalized license plate, not one that said bitch on it, but it was a gift from my mom. And it matches the one that I sent her, so. My mom's kind of funny, she's German and she has trouble getting American sayings right. Like when you guys were kids, your parents probably said it's only funny until somebody gets hurt. My mom said it's only funny when somebody gets hurt. I was talking to my mom on the phone the other day, and she said, "You know what, Micheline, you are the salt of the earth." I'm like, "Hey, mom, that's cool. You mean I've added flavor to your life?" She's like, "Not exactly. It caused me to bloat, and you elevate my blood pressure." And my mom, she sent me this Christmas card last Christmas. It was beautiful. It was like Norman Rockwell, but on the inside, she wrote a little note, "By the way, the dog is dead." Like, she could not have found a better way to tell me. Like, ixnay on the odd day would have worked for me. I don't know. How about like a picture of the dog in a circle with a slash across? That would have been good too. Or you can make your own cards now, right? So she could have the little Norman Rockwell family sitting around an empty wicker basket, dog collar hanging on the wall. You could open it up and it would say something like, "The Christmas season can make you heady. Your dog is dead. Over it already." I don't know, I think that would have been better. My mom kind of, she worries about me. Because I live in California now, she worries about the earthquakes. So I thought, you know what, if we have the big one, Why not be practical? I think the best place to be, tanning bed. No mess, instant coffin, boom. And that way, millions of years from now, I could be unearthed as the sun goddess. Or if they dig up my car, the bitch sun goddess. But, you know, it's like, because you don't know, because with history, it gets so distorted, you just don't know. Like King Tut. How do we know that King Tut was not just a camel dung dealer and the Great Pyramids were not just a gay bathhouse? Like Tutankhamun, for all we know, really means one who is light in the sandals. King Tut, I don't know, maybe Queen Tut would be more appropriate. I should probably go ahead and do my closer for you. I'm gonna give you the definition of a humanoid. Does anybody know? It's a midget that clings to your asshole. That's my time, guys. Comedian. He is wonderful. You're going to love him. He's been all over Orange County. Please welcome to the stage with a big round of applause for Ron McCoy.
Song for tonight's 1 year anniversary, Marty, and I'd like to go ahead and play it for you now. It's funny, this song came to me just the other day when I was taking the dog for a walk. So it goes a little like this. Now, in my opinion, the greatest song ever written. It's the start of a brand new day. Things are starting to go my way. But there's just one thing you know you can count on. Is that the best part of waking up? When it's Folgers in your cup. How about that song for the opening of the brand new Oprah Winfrey show? You found out that your husband is gay and that the children are moving away. But there's just one thing you know you can count on. Is that the best part of breaking up? Is you get half the stuff and you can watch it on the Oprah Winfrey Show. Thank you. What walks downstairs, a loner in pairs, and makes a sliggity sound. A bing, a bong, a marvelous song. Everyone loves a slinky, a slinky, a slinky. For fun, it's a wonderful toy. A slinky, a slinky. It's fun for a girl and a boy. Now, how about that song for the number one female entertainer in the world today? She walks downstairs, a loner in pairs, she makes a sliggity sound. A bing, a bong, a marvelous song. Everyone screwed Madonna, Madonna, Madonna. For fun, she's a wonderful toy. Madonna, Madonna, she's fun for a girl and a boy. I don't know if you guys know this or not, last month, I guess, Chelsea Clinton had a big birthday, and she had a big party, and what was really neat is that she got to invite over some of her teenage girlfriends to spend the night at the White House, and I thought, that would be cool. But today is President Clinton's birthday. Coincidentally, he invited over the same teenage girls. So go ahead. Like to play for you now my exit song. This song is the brand new administration's condom distribution song. Here we go. Double, double your affection. Double, double your erection. Whoa, no single condom can still freshen your mouth like double mint, double ribbed condoms. Double, double your affection. Double, double your erection. Whoa, no single condom can still freshen your mouth like double mint, double ribbed. Come on and double it. Double mint, double ribbed condoms. I'm Ron McCoy. Thank you.
McCoy, we're gonna wait for a 3-minute commercial. We'll be right back. Don't go away, guys. Get us out of here.
Somebody?
Marty's talking here.
About 3 minutes?
And I'm talking
in this
more.
Show.
Hey, Marty, look at me after the show.
How much time we got now? I'm sure they're going crazy in the control room right now.
Heavenly Holy, singing hallelujah.
There you go. Please clap. Thank you very much.
Take it away. Okay, that was the best of clip. We had no audio, but
that was the best of sounds of silence.
Okay, next up
we actually
have
communicate
another...
with the hearing impaired.
Huh?
That's our clipboard where we communicate with the hearing impaired. Thank you.
Thank you. I hope you were signing.
Yeah, I love all of you, okay?
All right, here we go. We have another group of dancers coming out. Norma Weiss is back with us again this evening with Dance Magique. Please welcome Dance Magique. And Dance Magique, weren't they great? Exit, thank you. I don't know about those twirly things. I'd probably have an accident with those. Those are pretty wild. I have to find out what those are called. Okay, we have two more funny people coming up again. Barry Weisenberg and Alex Pages are back with us again this evening. They are different as night and day. You'll see physically their brand of comedy. You'll find out what I mean in a second. Let's welcome Barry Weisenberg.
How you guys doing tonight? All right, hey, before I start, how about a nice round of applause? 1 year of the Marty Shield Show, let's hear it. Come on. Great to be here, great to be here. I'll tell you, it's been kind of an odd day for me today. I was driving through Hollywood today, I gotta ask you guys a question. Is it normal for a condom shop to have a blowout sale? Apparently not. So I'm real excited. Last week I joined a health club, and when I joined, their ad said, pay nothing for 90 days. So far I haven't paid my rent, my electric bill, my telephone bill. So I was in a bar the other night, and I guess I don't know how to talk to women, because this one woman says to me, you know, I hope you're not the type of guy who says they're gonna call and then actually does. I said, no, don't want to ruin my image. So there's a daycare center near me that now offers breastfeeding. So far, I've been through the line twice. By the way, I gotta say, the comedy's been going very well for me. By applause, how many people have cable? HBO, Cinemax, Showtime? If you guys do have HBO or Cinemax, you may have seen me recently. I'm an installer. Yeah, I gotta admit, the social thing is really bad for me. You know, I rarely date or hardly go out. I don't know, sometimes I think I'm at that point in my life that a lot of guys can relate to, where the women I want don't want me, and the women I don't want me. And I have to admit, I've never been very good at relationships, especially sex, you know. I have boxer shorts that have written on them, "Objects are bigger than they appear." Yeah, it's tough to meet women, don't you think? You know, the bar scene and all that. You know, I have to admit that over the years, I've sort of developed my own unique approach to picking up women. Although the police like to refer to it as stalking. And you think about all the things that women do to keep their bodies in shape, right? Like, you guys go out and you get breast implants, you get fat injected into your lips, you have tummy tucks, you get your stomach stapled. I mean, you take a woman out nowadays, on her butt it says some assembly required. You know, I guess I should tell you guys a little bit about my last girlfriend, because I just heard from her a few days ago. She sent me a 3-page letter. Well, okay, she calls it a restraining order. You know, and sometimes I think about our first date. I mean, I'm surprised we stayed together after that, because it just didn't go well. I picked her up and took her to a drive-in theater. Got lost, it took me 2 hours to get there. Well, the whole time, that's all she did was complain. Let me out of the trunk, let me out of the trunk. So I just got notice about my college reunion. I'm really excited about that. You know, I did a couple dumb things when I was in school. When I was in college, I studied languages, you know, French, Spanish. The reason I took French in college was because I kept getting deja vu mixed up with ménage à trois. See, I kept sleeping with people who I thought already knew me. And I always did lousy in school because I never gave the right answers. Like one time on a test, a teacher asked, "What caused the Great Depression?" So I put, "Living with my parents." I went to kind of a drug-oriented high school not too far from here. You guys may have heard of it. It was called High High. We had a lot of students at the school who really stood out. We had one student who played on all the football team, the basketball team, all the sports, happened to be an American Indian, very popular. So at our homecoming dance, we let him have the first dance, which was great, but then it rained for 36 days straight. So, you know, last few years I've been living at home again, and I'm starting to have all kinds of fights with my parents. The other day my dad comes up to me and he says, "You know, you live in a world of make-believe. You never face reality." I said, "I'm gonna pretend you didn't say that." Yeah, and my home life isn't going so good because my parents are always fighting. Like yesterday, my father tells my mom that all he wants to do is leave and run away from everything. So my mom says, "On your mark?" And I'll leave you guys with this thought. The other day, a friend of mine got me some condoms that are packaged to look like gold coins. Have you guys seen these? I mean, they don't really do me a whole lot of good, but they make great tips in restaurants. You guys are a terrific crowd. My name is Barry Weisberg. Thanks a lot. I want to bring to the stage now a brilliant comedian, a gentleman I have worked with many times, appears all around LA and Orange County. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the great comedy of Mr. Alex Pages.
Gotta give me some roadies. How's everybody doing tonight? Anniversary show? I thought I'd address the obvious. Am I having a damn good hair day or what?
Actually, I'm test marketing a new hairspray. They only sell it to stand-up comics and evangelists. It's called Aquanet BP. Bulletproof? If you're wearing this hairspray, you're exempt from the helmet law. Actually, when people first see me, they try to figure out what I am. They'll go, is he Mexican? Filipino? Somebody even thought I was Chinese one day. Of course, it was really bright out that day. Actually, I'm from Ecuador. I speak Spanish, but that's no big deal. What bugs me, though, is when people just automatically assume that I can't speak any English. For instance, the other day I was at this restaurant. Okay, a little fast. All right, it was Taco Bell. Kid behind the counter takes one look at me. He goes, that'll be $2.65. Do you understand? I'm like, yeah, what are you, retarded or something? Right then, the owner comes over and says, actually, we hired the mentally handicapped. I'm like, oh. Look, kid, I'm sorry. I didn't know. He goes, that's okay, you stupid beaner. Us Latinos, we've had our darker moments. In fact, I was in LA during the riots, and it disgusted me to see people of my color, you know, robbing and looting. But the scariest part came when somebody actually took a shot at me. If it hadn't been for that TV I was carrying, I'd be dead right now. Pretty violent out there, too. You gotta be careful out there. I was shopping over in Brea Mall, and I got in a fight over a parking space. I pull into this parking space, this person gets out of their car, runs up to me, socks me in the stomach, popped me in the mouth, floored me. Man, I got so pissed off, I said, forget all that stuff they taught me about, you know, not hitting women. I kicked her 80-year-old ass all over that parking lot. Then her granddaughter gets out of the car, tries to start something with me, so I pick up grandma's cane and I start hitting her with it. You know the white one with the red tip on it? I found out about a movie that's coming out pretty soon. They were gonna make it, but they haven't got enough money to let them write the script. So get ready next summer for Star Trek VII, The Wrath of Kirk. You guys wanna see a scene from this? Yeah. Captain, I can't fix the transporter. I can't give you a 1-5. Dr. McCoy smoked out of the lithium crystals. Damn, it's gone. Why is it? But the only thing on my ship that works. Is your microwave oven and your refrigerator. You fat bastard. Lieutenant Uhura is suing me for sexual harassment. It's because I've boldly gone where no man has gone before. This is McCoy and Captain Kirk at the annual physical. Damn it, Bones, I've been coughing for 30 minutes. Let go of my echoes. So real quick impersonation, you guys try to figure out who this is here.
Madonna.
Hi. Do you remember me? I used to pitch for the Dodgers. That's why I carry the American Express card. It's the only other green card I don't leave home without. You know, a lot of people kid me about my weight, you know, so I finally decided to do something about it. I went to Yenny Craig. And in just 2 short weeks, I lost $435. Thank you. If I could have a little music, please. What would the King of Rock and Roll be doing today if you were still alive? Other than beating the shit out of Michael Jackson. Well, you are about to find out.
Zedan concert one time. It was really dark up here. I kicked the shit out of my whole band. I'll be singing karaoke, by the way, which is Japanese for, where is the fucking band? This is on my new album. Hope you like it. All right, you guys in the front row, you can stop staring at my ass now. See, I'll remember the words. Well, my name is Ellis, I'm sure you know. I started rock and roll a long time ago, but this time I'm back, here to stay. All you other rappers, get out of my way. 15 years since I last got down. A lot of people saying I was in the ground. Here to tell you, it's all bullshit, cause when it comes to rapping, I'm too legit to quit. Thank you very much, I'm Alex Baby.
One, two, three, four. Can anybody hear me but me? Yeah. Can you hear me? Yeah. Thank you for sticking with us. We'd like to go ahead and do our last video clip of the evening, which is the best of, and God, I hope we have audio on this one. So are we ready to go in the truck? Let's go and look at the last best of, and we'll continue with the show. Take it away, guys.
Again, 45 seconds a minute. Now let's go.
Sorry. We're going out to commercial. We'll be right back. I'm so sorry. Take us away, guys.
Okay, so and so Arthur Prejna is a Polish name?
Well, Prejna isn't really a Polish name. You know,
oh, it's not.
Most Polish names end in, like, ski.
That's what I was wondering. So what nationality is Prejna? Do you know?
I really don't know.
Oh.
If you know, please give us a call, 333-2427. Give us a call down here.
Award being offered.
Yes. Definitely.
We're out of focus, though. What's going on in the control room?
Somebody saw.
John, Craig, are you guys in the control room? Are you guys watching me at all? Randy, let's go see what the heck's going on in the control room. Randy, why don't you come with me? Hold on a second. Here's my
bucket.
Let's see what's going on in the control room. Come on, Randy, let's go. Excuse everybody. We're just going to go see what's going on in the control room. Hold on.
Oh,
it's
been a very
odd
show. I'm going to go to the control room right now.
You guys in there? Come on, let's go on.
It's in the control room.
What the heck is going on in here? Oh my God, it's Pogs! It's Pogs, ladies and gentlemen! This is Pogs. The newest thing to sweep the United States, Pogs.
I saw Mommy kissing Santa Claus underneath the mistletoe.
We forgot to play.
Oh man, that was.
Thank you.
We can only go
you
up.
You guys
from here.
Started getting him sweating over here.
I know.
Here.
I'm trying to lose it.
I'll hold that for you if you want. I don't say that much to guys, but I say it for him.
Laura, you're gonna hold that for me.
We'll just do it.
Can I say that on the air?
Is that politically correct? Let's hear it for the best of clip. All right. Okay. Next up, we have another dance group, and the ladies get to enjoy this time because we got guys in this one. Guys. Pecs, biceps. Here we are. Let's welcome the Mauna Loa dancers.
I'm killing time right now. So this drunk walks into a bar. You know what I mean? Anybody know any jokes? Oh, they're drunk. They're drunk. We don't want to talk to them. We're going to go ahead and fump her as I go. Is that it? 2, 3, 4. Everybody's looking at me. Who am I talking to? No, I don't have tap yet. Hold on a second. Excuse me. Pardon me. Here we go. Here we go, man.
Never took a lesson, ladies and gentlemen.
Take it away, lady! Are you guys going some more? We got more? We got more? You got more? You sure? You sure you can't do that? This kind of improv? I love drummers. I love to hear drummers all day long. At this time, I'd like to bring out, why don't you come on out? We have a musical group. I also roadie, as you can tell. A musical group. How many microphones do you see? Ladies and gentlemen, can you please hear for the Love Toys? The Love Toys, ladies and gentlemen! The Love Toys! Keep your on, Cap. Check 1, 2. Are you on?
Check 1, 2.
Check 1, 2. I'm getting out of here. Take it away,
check.
Guys. Take it away.
We are the Love Toys. Going out for our last commercial. We'll be back for the end of the show. Guys, take it away. The Love Toys, huh?
The Love Toys.
As you can tell, it's very live.
Too live.
We don't tape record like all the other shows like Letterman does. And
because we can't afford it.
We can't afford it, and we'd rather go live. The last act for the evening is a young lady who appeared, I believe, on our February show or our March show. And when she was at the studio, she just blew the roof off the place. So we hope that the...
That's why we're here.
The structural engineers have done a good job here. And I said... please give a warm welcome to an incredible young lady from Rolling Heights. Beautiful Rolling Heights. That's a cheap plug. Ladies and gentlemen, can you please hear it for Miss Tamara Wells? Tamara Wells, ladies and gentlemen, Tamara Wells. Thank you. beautiful Rolling Heights, California. Rolling Heights, give me a Rolling Heights one time. It's that time of the evening where we need to get out of here. There's a few thank yous we'd like to go ahead and thank before we're gone this evening. I'm picking this microphone out of here. We'd like to thank Pizza Hut in Hacienda Heights for giving us food tonight, Pizza Hut. We'd like to thank the Pony Ready Mix for letting us have this big TV we're using tonight, Pony Ready Mix in City of Industry. We'd like to thank Southwest Concrete for also the food they gave us tonight. Southwest, give it Southwest.
Yeah. Give me a big old hug, you lug.
We also like to thank Rent-A-Chef, who'll be here. I said, if you're watching, come on down. We're gonna be here for another 2 hours. Come on, Lori, come on in.
We're gonna have a big old group hug.
Oh.
Actually, they're holding me up.
We'd like to thank TCI Cablevision, the City of Industry, and also Channel 33. Can we hear for them? Yeah.
Woo! Come on! And more than anything else.
No, not more than anything. We need to thank all the techs. We want to thank Craig Bryant and John Carpy and Diane Mattingly and Phil George
and Carmen Shields,
Randy Davis, Jack Rodriguez, Jason, Andrea, Paul, where's David? All the people have helped out on the show.
Charlie and Jackie.
Everybody here. And we'd like to give a special thank you.
Tom.
And Tom Delisle. I'm sorry, Tom. He's going to kill me. And we'd like to say a special thanks to two people who are not here tonight. And we're saddened by that. We'd like to say thank you to Frank Atencio Sr. and Tony Uriarte, huh?
Yeah.